one dear brothers and sisters of Sai family. It's my dream to be in Delhi, a dream to spend a couple of days that has not been possible all these years. I followed Swami twice on his visit for the inauguration of the Sai Center, International Center. Following Swami, you cannot look that side and this side. You should look at him only. If you are found then, looking that side or this side, car doors will be opened and you will ask to get down immediately. So with focused attention, with undiluted concentration, without diversion of attention, you should just look at him, and hence I could not look at Delhi by and large.
पहले तो मैं कहूँगी कि बहुत डिफिकल्ट टास्क है, जिस एनर्जी से जोश से आप बोलते हैं, फिर भी कोशिश करूँगी कि जो आप कह रहे हैं मैं आप सब तक पहुँचा सकूँ. सबसे पहले उन्होंने कहा कि दिल्ली की विजिट उनके लिए एक स्वप्न के समान था, और जब वो दो बार दिल्ली आने का उनको अवसर मिला, एक बार इनॉग्रेशन पर और एक बार ही बाबा के साथ वैसे जब बाबा विजिट कर आए थे. उनका कहना है कि जब आप स्वामी के साथ होते हो तो आपको केवल स्वामी की ओर देखना है, बिल्कुल फोकस होकर. अगर आपने इधर उधर देखा तो कोई बड़ी बात नहीं कि कांच का दरवाजा खोल के उसी समय आपको नीचे उतार दिया जाए. और इसी फोकस, इसी अटेंशन के साथ, क्योंकि मैं हर समय स्वामी को देखता था, मुझे दिल्ली देखने का मौका नहीं मिला, क्योंकि उनके साथ होते हुए मैं इधर उधर नहीं देख पाता था.
Now, during that trip, he arranged for boys to see some important places like Parliament and Rashtrapati Bhavan from a distance. I'm speaking in front of Swami. When I saw those buildings from a distance, for a short time, because divine time is always short, you cannot take the risk. Just look at the bus or something. You know what I felt? Believe me or not, those that have not seen Delhi are not Indians at all. If you are a true Indian, you must see the Delhi, the great capital of this greatest country, India. You see, ashamed very much to say that I do not know the national language Hindi. It is a minus point in my life. Perhaps Baba must have thought, if this fellow also knows Hindi, world will not be safe in his hands. So she purposely made me totally new to the Hindi language. But adding spice to the life, my wife did some Hindi diploma and I do not know any Hindi. And I was successful, very successful, in making her forget Hindi. She was very unsuccessful in making me learn one or two words at least. So, though I do not know the national language, at least for this life, I shall see the national capital, the Delhi, the great experiences. All experiences are divine. All experiences are divine. Nothing particular divine experiences. Particularly with Swami, there is no scope for anything else to experience other than the divine. So let me say few things about how I got into this world, because the district president brought to your attention few details of my biodata about which I am not proud of. But since it is brought in public, better I do it all by myself. Believe me or not, I never had any faith in Swami. No faith at all. Not only me here, all the family for three generations never had any faith in Rama, Krishna, Venkateshwara, nothing doing. We belong to a religion by the name Brahma Samaj. Brahma Samaj is the religion founded by Raja Ram Mohan Roy from Calcutta. Keshav Chandra Sen, Saroji Naidu, Rabindranath Tagore, Devendranath Tagore, Pandit Sitaranath Tathabhushan, they are all followers of Brahma movement. So for three generations, they are nothing like idolatry. We believe in Upanishadic approach to God. What is Upanishadic approach? God has no birth. God has no form. God has no end. The formless, the beginningless, endless, divine is the one we contemplate. Yes, sir.
मेरा कहना है कि मेरे परिवार में तीन जनरेशन्स तक कोई भी किसी भी भगवान में विश्वास नहीं करता था और मेरा तो बिल्कुल भी भगवान में विश्वास नहीं था क्योंकि हम लोग ब्रह्म समाज के सदस्य थे. ब्रह्म समाज को ये माना जाता था कि भगवान अनादि है, अनंत है, ना उसका जन्म है ना उसकी मृत्यु है और किसी भी देवी देवता की हम लोग पूजा नहीं करते थे और किसी भगवान केवल इतना मानते हैं कि जो हमारा उपनिषद के सत्य हैं अनादि अनंत जिसके बारे में कुछ कहा नहीं जा सकता जिसको केवल अनुभव ही किया जा सकता है वही केवल भगवान था. और ब्रह्म समाज के बहुत बड़े बड़े लोग हुए जैसे राजा राममोहन राय, रविंद्रनाथ टैगोर और कई भी और उन्होंने नाम लिए. मैं भी उसी क्योंकि विश्वास में था तो कभी भी भगवान को नहीं माना था, कोई भी श्रद्धा नहीं थी, कोई पूजा नहीं थी किसी किसी भगवान की.
All national leaders belonged to Brahma Samaj in those days. My grandfather went to Calcutta. He underwent training in Brahma movement. He is a great missionary in the state of Andhra Pradesh for the spread up of Brahma movement in the whole state of Andhra Pradesh. He is a scholar in English, Bengali, Telugu and Sanskrit. He read so many books. He traveled length and breadth, sacrificed all of life for the spread of Brahma movement. In those days, women had no opportunity to have higher education. It was also a custom that the girls get married at the age of 8, E-I-G-H-T. They should get married at the age of 8. They had no opportunity to have higher studies. I proudly declare that my mother is the first lady graduate from Andhra Pradesh. Queen Mary's College Madras, post graduation in English literature and won gold medals in English literature. Later, she served as district education officer and retired. I can frankly say, one girl is here known to her very well, intimately. Can proudly say, she is the most beautiful girl in the college, college beauty of those days, my mother, you can believe. Simple background of the family, there are many more things to say, but the lecture, the subsequent events, episodes are more important. I will cut short the family background at this stage. Now, there are no photographs of Rama, Krishna, Venkateshwara, nothing in our house. Because at 7 o'clock, we are assembled, pray silently, meditate, and disperse. That's all. There is nothing like puja, or nothing like upanayanam, no yaga, no yajna, no yajnopavetam, nothing. Just meditation, informless beingness, endless God. That is the family tradition for three generations. Started my career as a lecturer in Andhra Christian College at Guntur, and was also former student of the same college. A gentleman thought that I am good enough to get his daughter married to me for the simple reason that we don't accept dowries, Brahma discipline. And he made a query of my conduct and character in the AC College because it's a co-education institution. And he thought, as on today is okay. Somehow he dared and came forward, offered his daughter in marriage to me, whom you see there on the other side. We just got married only 53 years ago, not much.
मैंने अपना career शुरू किया as a lecturer in Andhra Pradesh Christian College, Guntur में. मैंने अपनी शिक्षा भी यहीं पर प्राप्त की थी. एक सभ्य व्यक्ति जो मुझसे अपनी बेटी की शादी करना चाहते थे, वो मेरे बारे में बहुत अधिक जानना चाहते थे और उन्होंने बहुत हिम्मत करके मेरे बारे में जानना भी. और उसके बाद मेरा विवाह विजय लक्ष्मी जी से हो गया, जिनको आप यहाँ बैठे हुए थे.
The paradox of life, the irony of life is this. Like poles repel, unlike poles attract. She comes from a family of 100% Hindu rituals. Day begins with worship, day is spent in worship, day ends in worship, and all kinds of pujas, everything. She has joined here from capital economy to communist economy. What to do? To be or not to be, that is the question. This is India, where once you get married, your life ends there. You cannot have any change. So, what to do? Comes from a traditional family. She brought with her, I suppose, a small picture of Lord Venkateshwara, which she kept under the pillow to do underground worship like Nazarenes.
क्या करें क्या ना करें, क्योंकि भारत में माना जाता है कि जब एक बार शादी हो गई तो उससे कोई और छुटकारा नहीं है, उसको हमें निभाना ही है. तो जब आई तो अपने साथ लॉर्ड वेंकटेश्वरा की छोटी सी फोटो लाई, जो उसको अपने तकिए के नीचे रखती थी और सीक्रेट म्यूजिक से उनकी पूजा किया करती
थी. Announced in our house, you won't find me next day. What a crucifixion. What am I to do? She said, we should have such a. Sometimes we have to oblige women also. We have a normal, usual, casual, healthy life. So when she said, we should have it, we fixed the Satyana Puja at a temple far off from our place. Nobody will know. And I told her, you go to the Telugu street. I'll come from the college. At the end of the puja, you go home straight. I go to the college straight. Both of us come independently at different times so that nobody can ever doubt that we did any puja. Priests in particular, they put some kumkum or something like that. I was working in a Christian college. I cannot go like that. Even if Christians understand, my people will never forgive me. So all I did was immediately after puja, there is a tap behind the temple. I washed my face, pure and bright as before, went straight to the college. Straight to college. That was the situation. But till today, believe me or not, she goes in her own traditional style. I go in my own way of meditation, my own way of concentration, my own way of reading, my own way of traveling, my own understanding of Baba, and the most precious thing in my life, for which I want to live for any number of years that God decides, only to spread His message. No other ambition. I was a very, very busy man with 22 hours of work, not per day, for the whole week, teaching in practical classes, besides offering coaching at home and teaching in Ravi College. One girl we met there, she said that she was student of my Ravi College, 1964. When I met her there near Parliament House, sir, I was your student in 1964, or I believe me. I am up in the air. A student recognizes me, who was student in 64. But it brought in spirit of pride also, to feel I have not changed much, because she would recognize me. I started my life very early, before coming to Baba. Started a little slowly, each day. Is that I have learned in the later years. I started my life very early, as I got married at the age of 22. Start very early. So, be that as it may, somehow, as years passed, suddenly, she complained of some pain. What to do? And when I can also tell you now, I never stood first in the class. I never secured any gold medal. I never made any research paper presentation at any national, international conferences. No. But right from first form, sixth class, what you say, up to university, MSc final year, I stood school first, college first, university first, in inter-university elocution debating contest. That is my background in this field of public speaking. Rotary Club, Lions Club, JC Club, this club, that club. All school anniversaries, all college anniversaries, no platform without Anil Kumar. That was my days of hectic, dynamic, vital activity in those years. Of course, even now, in a different direction. At that time, she complained some problem, pain. So, I returned from Lions Club making a wonderful talk, people slam. By the time I returned home, pain. The pain cannot be gained to me. Another, it frustrates me. She had been complaining of that pain. What to do? I took her to many doctors in Guntur. We have many doctors who are trained abroad. Very busy practitioners, experts in the field. About 8 of them I consulted. And all of them said, fine, but she needs surgery. Without that, it may lead to cancer. So she had got to be operated upon. And as early as possible, they said, it was fixed April 6th for the surgery to be done to her. And into April, May, June, you don't need any frying pan. Stand on the street, you become Papa Dance Man. First class flying, that was the season that is the date fixed for the surgery. Then she was admitted to hospital. She was operated. She was fine next day. But I must also confess, just on the previous day of the surgery, I translated the talk of the governor of Andhra Pradesh, Kannubai Deshai, at Gandhi Park. Next morning she was operated. You can imagine how irresponsible I am. But doesn't matter if truth is known, as the cat came out of the bag. So, next morning she was operated. By the time I came to the hospital, she already has gone to the surgery, to the theater, by walk. That's what I was told. Fine. See, she returned. I showed for 2-3 days, a week so, and she returned back home. Everything fine. But story did not stop there. Then she started again in pain. Pain number two. What is she done? A fellow like me, going around and talking to everybody, meeting everybody, teaching, learning both the hands, teaching botany to medical students. What am I to do? Then I took her around doctors, again another round. They all said, she is fine. Some even joked, better you cook at home, you have rest. Some even said, better you take care of the children, you have rest. So I have become an object of jokes, an object of laughter to doctors, because they are all telling that she is fine, what am I? She was not eating anything else other than rice and buttermilk, that's all. If anything, she said burning sensation, what good? Then I thought, doctor says she is fine. She says she is not fine. Am I to be fine or not? That is my question. Then I told her, look here, you come from a traditional family of deities, gods, statues, worship and all that. We'll do one thing. Daily I take to you one temple, daily. You go there, inside, pray and come out. But don't force me to get in. I am Brahmo. That's it. You go and worship, no objection. But I take you. Every day we used to visit one temple. She goes inside the temple with children and she comes out, we go back. I have met children play in the place around. But she is finding some peace of mind, if not totally pure. So that was continuing. At one time, when we were just passing by, we heard some bhajans. She said, why don't we go? Okay, let me go. I climbed the steps, attended bhajans. Saw there very big photograph such as Sai Baba. Hare Baba Baba. The family that has no faith in Rama and Krishna and Venkateshwara, such as Sai Baba. What will happen to me? What will happen to the prestige of the family? What will happen to me? But anyhow, I sat far behind where chapels are kept. Sat far behind. I don't want to be polluted, adulterated, or diluted. Remain pristine, pure, crystal clear, Brahmo. So I went there. At the end of the bhajan, she came home and said, why don't we go to Puttaparthi? You know Ramayana, Kaika wanted a boon that led to the death of Dasharatha. Her desire to take her to Puttaparthi is my position of Dasharatha. Her desire is like Kaika's wish. Because I know that my people will never tolerate it. But what I did was, I slowly approached my grandmother. Grandmother's grandfather's are so nice when they are grand. But when their parents very tough, as parents, every fellow is a great man. The moment he becomes a grandfather, he becomes a butter, as soft as butter and butter. So, I approached my grandmother, told her she wants to go there and see. Yes, but we managed to get permission from grandfather. I don't dare to ask him because he spent his life for a Brahma movement. I said, how can I do it? She said, Ali, what is this? Stop this idea, give up this idea, your grandfather won't accept. Evening again, I think, polished her feet and approached him, I don't do it. Then she approached slowly my grandfather and said, he wants to go to Puttaparthi. Yes, it is. And then further she said, you are a Brahmo and your parents are traditionalists. When you became Brahmo, when you turned into Brahmo faith, your parents also must have been upset very much. Have you not upset your parents? After that, why is that making you upset? He wants to go and come back. Slowly, he made the BP of my grandfather come down and normal. So silently, we were given permission to go to work. We were accompanied by my mother-in-law, the pakka Andhra spicy meals, hot, hot stuff, so that we feel quite at home. But I laid some conditions for my wife. If you want me to take you to Puttaparthi, condition number one, don't ask me to get into Mandir. Don't insist that I should do Namaskar to Baba, nothing doing. Number two, many devotees say that they stay there for months and months and months. I cannot afford to stay for months and months. It's a Christian college. Job is only source of income and livelihood. So not more than 4 to 5 days, right? Suppose she was happy because I could take her there. And we reached Puttaparthi, completely new to the place. There is one so-called Holiday Inn, a so-called hotel for namesake. It is not that. It is such a funny rooms rented out. How are they? You can remove the window and keep it there. You can remove the main door and keep it on the floor again, fix it. And you get the moonlight and sunlight into the room. And everything, the calls of nature, there in the open university. That's all. There is no restroom, there is no bathroom, there is toilet. That's it. That's only arrangement in those days. I got very much annoyed. What a funny place is this. I had to come there. Somehow I swallowed it like a bitter pill and then started. She used to go every day, sit there with children, along with my mother-in-law. But children can't sit that long. I made them play there. Because at that time, Purnachandra auditorium was under construction. Heap of sand, pebbles, make them play. But I never went inside. I never did any namaskar to Swami. I can also tell you, when students ask me before examinations, sir, tell us some important questions. My usual answer is, I am not such a Sai Baba to tell you important. Further, if any fellow has a lot of hair, I'll wait you have that much of hair like Sathya Baba. I don't like it. And also, two girls. One girl had a ring with Baba's picture there. Another girl with a chain with Baba's picture. I asked them to get out of the class. And third thing is, I used to get by heart. Get by heart. a Blitz magazine edited by R.K. Karanjia. R.K. Karanjia, the great. Prose becomes poetry. In the love of English literature, though I am not student of literature, I am student of biology, but I love English literature. I used to read R.K. Karanjia articles, get them by heart. He was dead against Baba in those days, and speak eloquently to demonstrate my excellence, linguistic gimmicks to all my students. Karanjia wrote some articles with title like this: Is Baba God or Fraud? He wrote another article, Baba the Charlatan, the Magic Man. Such articles he wrote. I freely got them by my hands. Such a man in Buddhavati today. 3 or 4. But lunchtime, there was some parliamentary session between me and my wife. Parliamentary session means what? That which has never come. What is that session? She always tells me, why can't you go inside and teach our darshan once? I said, what is the condition? The condition is, you should not insist me to get it. My guts. I am not going to be converted, certainly not. Somehow days proceeded like that. Just 1 more day left to go catch the bus and go back. And on penultimate day, previous day, I stood there in the Gopuram gate with children. I had 4 children, 3 daughters and a son. The youngest one was not even 1 year, the youngest daughter is not even 1 year old at the time, once maybe. But standing there at the Gopuram gate, because Gopuram gate is safe. I will not be baptized. I will not be brainwashed. I cannot be influenced. I was standing there. Bhajan was going on in full swing. I could see Baba on the chair in the mandir, just doing that bhajan session. I could not see him clearly. Suddenly he got up. Usually in bhajan session, people told me later that he will never get up. And once he sits on the chair, until half is over, usually he will not get up. That day he got up. Right from Mandir up to Gopuram gate, he walked towards me and stood in front of me. What was my feeling? I would know for the first time what shake dance is. Legs were trembling, voices fumbling, hands are shaking. I could not be steady. He came and stood in front of me. I was praying, why should you be here? There are many devotees, please go there. Leave me alone. I never wanted to. Please. Then I thought that he would not go until he goes Namaskar. Stopped there. They refused to join. Swami looked at this man, and he went back, sat on his chair. Then I thought, he must have come for some purpose. 2 minutes were over. Second time he got up. All the way he came and stood in front of me. Refused to go. There is no way. Then he just He went close to the Purnachandra auditorium, which was under construction. Many laborers, they were doing their work. Swami went like this. Suddenly, he went close to the laborer. A plate appeared in his hand, a plate with the laddus. And therefore the plate has come. If the plate has come, how about the laddus? Is it true what Karanji has said? Karanji has said so many things about Baba. Maybe true. What is this plate? What are these laddus? He started distributing one laddu to everybody. Then I thought, I can give you one or two laddus to my children. So he started with the laddu level of devotion. I took children close to Swami so that he gave them laddus. He did not turn back. Last laddu to the last worker. Plate vanished. He simply walked into mandir. That was the first miracle I witnessed. Now, I want to have a close look at Baba because I need to go. So I sat there on the sand. In those days, many darshans. Coffee, Swami goes that way, you have darshan. Interview, second darshan. Before Bhajan, third darshan. During Bhajan, he goes to that Gokulam, fourth darshan, many, many darshans like that in those days. So I wanted to look at him. I saw Bhagavan moving along the veranda on upstairs of Prashant Nilayam, waving his hand into the empty air, the beautiful smile, and the halo of hair moving something like golden daffodils along the Milky Way. Then I thought, if you are really God, bring her back to normal health. I have come here for a health problem. If her health is okay, then I have accepted that you are divine. That's what I thought. Then I saw one of my students. Today, in the superintendency, such as I, higher secondary school today, he was my student in the year 1964. He retired as Union Bank manager. By name Srimanara, he's working there. He sat by me and said, "Sir, you are here." Because he heard my nonsense earlier. "Sir, you are here. Is it true?" It was true then. It is true now. Understand that. Then I started looking on all sides. There is no Pundi as in Tirupati. There is no collection of funds. How is that so many buildings have come up? How? Is it true what Karanji has said? Karanji has become my mental obsession. Because I studied it thoroughly. How? I did not tell anybody that my student told me, "Sir, we are wondering how these buildings have come up." I said, I did not tell you. Why are you asking? "Sir, when you are looking like that, I thought you have got this door." "All right. What do you say?" "No, sir. In Purnachandra Kamani was responsible for the construction of all the buildings. That's all. No donation, nothing." Then I realized what a Himalayan dimension of foolishness I had. One devotee constructed them all. I started doubting how they happen without any collection. One devotee did it all. The South Prashanti, the East Prashanti, and the central Purnachandra auditorium, wrong bill by Kamani at that time from Bombay. Then I thought, it is not safe to sit by the side of this man because he may bring out some more rotten thoughts in my mind. Then I shifted from there, sat somewhere else. There another elderly man sat by my side. I was looking like that. Swami was calling some people for interview. He said, "Are you wondering why you are not called? Are you wondering why you are not called?" That thought is there in my mind. That boy was dangerous. This elderly man is much more dangerous. Where to go now? Sorry, it's all right. I'm wondering why he doesn't call me. I'm in dire need of his divine intervention and his divine help. Why does he not call me? Both of my parents are very, very honest to the core, known all over the place. Father is retired here and joined as a public instruction. Very honest people. And I'm not a gunda either. Why didn't you call and ask me? That was the question. And this man said, "What is your name? It is dangerous to tell my name." Then he said, "Let me know your good name." Then he said, "I am Nayudu, headmaster, Isarama High School." Then I introduced myself. Then he said, "Don't worry why Baba has not called you. He knows whom to call, when to call, why to call. You don't question him. He knows." How do I know that he knows? I asked, how do I know that he knows? Then he said, "In Anil Kumar, Swami gives one example. Three fellows got headache on the same day. One fellow was asked to fast that night. That's all. Another fellow was given injection. The third fellow was immediately operated. Now, the fellow was asked to fast. Not to be jealous of that, oh, he is operated, I have not been feeling it. He knows whom to operate. He knows. So why do you worry like that? Anil Kumar, no worry. Okay, sir, thank you. I am in that place again. Because here people seem to be very dangerous. Try to know your questions and all that. There are not decent questions. What to do? Then I went straight to the stores. Kasturi was in charge of publication division. All books are there in wooden boxes. I purchased Such As I Speaks, volume 5, that was available at that time. And I started reading. Wow! Sweeter than gulab jam. Sweeter than rasagola. Wow! I was reading, he's the same Swami of whom I have been thinking ill of him all these days. I felt like crying. I repented very much. What did he say? He spoke on nameless, formless, attributeless, nirakara, niranjana, abhyaya. That is what Ram Sumar said. He's speaking on Brahma principles in a better way. Then I went to the stores, purchased 10 books at this time. Returned to bundle of books. She looked at me, she thought, what happened to this fellow? The man who never prepared to come here, the man who gave some conditions, is now coming with bundle of books. What happened to him? Somehow, I returned home, started reading books. At that time, since most of the people know me because of my public speaking, they have come to know that I visited Puttaparthi. All Sai centers visited me. And I won't go anywhere unprepared. Because being a teacher, one has to prepare. If he's not, he's unfit to be a teacher. But he quits the job in the interest of the students. I used to read the literature thoroughly and speak. At that time, what happened? As things went on, we used to go to Bhajan every day. My grandparents are watching what is happening at home. My parents are also watching what happened. I told my grandparents, nothing happened to me. I'm still a Brahma. What our Baba speaks is nothing but Brahma principles, women's emancipation. Non-idolatry, social reform, spiritual efficacy, unity of religions, these are the cardinal principles of Brahma Samaja. Swami spoke on those things. So don't think that I am baptized, that I got converted, and same Brahma Guru. But the point is, why should you go to Bhajan every day? Suppose if we don't go to Bhajan one day, she would say, pain here. So Baba kept the remote operation in his hands. If we don't go, so he was like that. Went on, I tell you my friends, no interview, no Pada Namaskar, no chance of giving letter. I never wrote a letter. I know, throughout my career. No chance of placing flower at his feet. Nothing. But by the time we return home, she is 100% hale, healthy, totally recovered. For 7 long years, I attended every festival in Prasanna. Never got first line. Never got Adam's car, never got any interview, but I got addicted to Sai Baba. Sai Baba addiction. And that addiction has nothing to do with interviews or anything like that. The wine may give you a kick for a couple of hours. The wine gives you kick from womb to the tomb. That divine kick I had. So I was going every festival. I know he never looked at me. Okay, so what? But every time, whenever I returned from Bhakti, I avoided devotees. Because these devotees, hey, did you get Pada Namaskar? I mean, how to answer them? You are such a good man, Anil Kumar. Did you not get Pada Namaskar? Is it a compliment or what? It is an interpreter. Avoid them for 15 days, then go there. You get tortured by the devotees more than by God Himself. So beware of devotees who embarrass you with such questions. Situation for 7 long years. Then, to cut the story short, I'm not giving you other details, I cut the story short. We went with family and children. Prior to that, I went alone. Prior to that, I went alone to a place by name Hindupur, to give a talk on Ramayana. Ramayana, Anil Kumar, what is to speak on Ramayana? They asked me, I said yes. But in the program sheet came all Sanskrit professors, Telugu professors from all universities, they are the speakers. You cannot say, Anil Kumar, what is to your children? Then immediately I rang up to them, sir, excuse me, I don't know that these professors are going to speak. Please excuse me. That man said, impossible. program is finalized, then once, my friends, then once Sai program is fixed, then nothing like going back, come what may. It is so strong, it is bound to happen. Sir, you are coming. He kept back the receipt. So what did I do? As a teacher, I read Ram Katha Rasa Vahini. Atmaram is discourse especially delivered on Sri Ram Navami occasions made by own notes. I went to Hindu world. I tell my friends, secret of your success. Secret of your success. As a speaker, as a singer, as a professional, as an engineer, as a doctor, engineering, software, hardware, nowhere, whatever may be. Secret of success is such a sign of our people. Be 100% successful. So I talk about success. Why was it successful? I am not a professor. I am not a Sanskrit scholar. I am just a botanist. Why was it successful? Because others read books about Rama, from Valmiki Ramayana, from Tulasi Ramayana, from Kamba Ramayana, from Ananda Ramayana. Whereas I got information from Rama himself. So this is direct transmission. That is why I straight ahead. So there are new things, Swami said, new information that nobody heard before. I'm very, very happy. Then I was returned to have Baba Darshan. On the way, you can come to Puttaparthi have a Darshan and see what Baba would say. By the time I came to Puttaparthi, Swami left Puttaparthi. That is what is called iron leg. The bus conductor told me, sir, did you not see Swami's car? He's going to Anandapur, sir. Please get up. I got down, got into another bus to go to Anandapur. I went straight to Anandapur with my baggage. It is a girls' college that I know. Seeing my luggage, that watchman said, ah! Get up, he said. Nobody asked me to get out straight there. I'm sufficiently honorable and respectable at my native place. If that fellow says like that, he will not see the next day. My students love me so much, even today. So that part, I said, why not? Sir, this girl's done, so what? There are 2,000 girls in AC College where I work. 3,000 boys, why not? Nothing to do, sir. Stand there. Rayalaseema, that part of Andhra Pradesh, comprises people of the hardcore. If you discuss anything, they will take away your life. If they love you, they give you your life. Otherwise, Hari Om Tat Sat, take away. I know what kind of area it is. So I just stood outside the luggage. Swami was there. Managing committee was a governing body. Dr. Suri Bhagavantam, Dr. Balakrishna, Kraksi, Subbarao, Minister of the Municipality at that time. All those people, top people. Goldstein, they're all members of college managing committee. They were having a meeting. I was at the gate farm. The meeting was over. Swami climbed down the steps, stood in the veranda. The steps are white and bright. The walls are white, painted light in color. There in the veranda stands at the center surrounded by a galaxy of scientists of high national, international stature. Orange robed Baba, his lovely hair moving on either side, holding his dhoti on hand, a robe, looking like the Radha. Very handsome girl. I was thinking like that. But I cannot go near one. I was at the gate. Swami there. Believe me, my friends, I am fully conscious. I am fully aware of the fact that I am speaking in the august presence of God. There cannot be a single word which is not true. Standing there in the veranda, Swami shouted, "Hey, Anil Kumar, come here," he said. First, after 7 years, I thought the name of the watchman is Anil Kumar. Because for 7 years, what happened? 7 years. I was watching him. He said some kondappa or something. Oh, so you are not Anil Kumar, very good. I was just saying. Then Swami shouted again, "Hey, Guntur Kale, what you go, sir? Anil Kumar, come here." Wow. Then I ran, galloping like a race horse. Tama. Immediately fell at his feet. All were watching. This is the miracle. He introduced me to everybody. He's professor. He's a botany professor. He's from Guntur. He gave lecture last night. Hindu poor on Ramayana. It's a very nice talk. Boys like, girls like, old people like. Very good, very good. Who told him? Did he come in and listen to my talk? No. How does he? And then first question he said, "How is your wife?" After 7 years. I said, "Swami, she's quite all right." Then I said, "Swami, her problem brought me to you. Let me be honest." Then Swami said, "Vitalize, devotee." And he said, "Give her." "Okay, Swami, thank you." And then Baba said, "Come and attend Dasara." I never wanted to attend Dasara festival. Because busy season, who will give you accommodation? I'm not VIP. I was never a VIP. I am not a VIP now. I don't want to be VIP for God's sake. Let me remain as very insignificant person, VIP. Not very important person. There is nothing great to be important. Beauty lies in being unimportant. That is what religion is. In Prashantanayam, the usual answer is no. Go to accommodation. "Sir, I want to take a bath." "Go to darshan." "Sir, can I sit here for?" "Go to canteen." "Can I have a spoon of sambar?" No is a regular answer. So what am I to do? Nobody will give me accommodation. Nobody will give me a seat. What to do? Then I have to sit back row, stay there in the room with collapsible windows and doors as before, and then sat. One day, he came, stood in front of me and said, "Yemappa, pampinanu cherinda." "I sent, did you receive?" "Why did you send?" "This accommodation happened." "Swami, you have not sent any, I have not received any," I said. "Okay." Then he said, "Where are you staying?" financially no say, ayyo Baba. Then he called Kutumba Rao, the head of Prashantanayam, Charanjeeva Rao, he called both of them. Whenever this man comes to Prashantanayam, give him accommodation immediately. Don't charge him, say. Standing instructions. Till this day, I am not paid single paisa for the mind. But the mind standing instructions. Okay? By the time I returned back to the room, I saw my wife crying. I thought she had a pain again. She's not crying out of pain. She said, Baba has sent me seek Sathya. Ladies know only one language. The language of tears of joy and the language of tears of sorrow. Tears you don't know. He said, Swami has sent me seek Sathya. Oh, I see. That's why Baba asked me. I sent, have you received? That's what's meaning. Next day I sat there. When I sat there, Swami stood in front of me. It was the year 1978. He stood in front of me and said, your speech is down there. Is it true that you give speech? Shall I say yes? You may say hopeless. Shall I say no? That's the only thing I know. I just kept quiet. I also know that you dance while you speak. Oh, I see. I kept quiet. Say no. Next day, suddenly, Baba called me. Several fellows said, Swami wants you. I said, yes, I wanted him. He never wanted me. Just, I was sitting in auditorium, Purnachandra. So the several volunteer took me from behind into the Purnachandra auditorium toward the dais. Swami looked at me. Hello, dancer, how are you? Okay, Swami. Thoda baat karo. Give some message to us. We'll speak for some time. Okay, Swami. I said this. Just from the audience, that's all. No prior intimation, advance notice. Okay. I said that. At that time, two boys also spoke. One is Kamal Sahani from Bombay. Other is Ruchi Deshai of Vrindavan campus, they were speakers. Third, the humble self here. Come on, dancer. Please speak. Then I said, Swami, what shall I speak on? What is the subject? Subject is only Swami. What else you speak? Speak on Swami. Swami, which language? English. Puttaparthi is international center. You cannot speak your Telugu here. Speak in English. Okay, Swami. How long, Swami? So long you can. For half an hour, tala. At the end, Swami said, very nice Bangal. Very nice talk. I'll give you another chance again. And that same year, on Vijayadashmi day, he gave me a chance to speak in Telugu. That also went on then. And then I was to return back on Christian College. Principal is Shishupala. If you extend your leave, better you stay back at home. So I was about to go. The present principal of higher secondary school, Puttaparthi, Mr. Sivaram Krishna, was my old student. Why am I giving these details? For your verification if you want. for the benefit of the doubting thumbs. I know that all of you accepted me, but there may be one or two tables. For their purpose, I am giving you references. That principal Seva Krishna came and said, "Sir, did you take leave from Swami? Leave from Swami? I have not taken leave from him for all these 7 years. If I insisted on taking leave, I would have lost my job. I would have been on the street with a begging bowl. I'm sorry, I am away. No, sir, you should tell Swami." He has got onto the bus, unloaded all my luggage. Sir, quote question. Then I sat there in Bhulachandra auditorium. Next day, after Vijayadashmi, Swami came and said, won't sit there. Won't there what? There means what? There where I am seated? And Swami, there, Adhyana, Varanda, also. Sit there in the Varanda, he said. Who will allow me to Varanda? At that time, Delhi Seva were there in charge. The North Indian people, to the extent I know, are very strong because they are wheat people. They need wheat. But South India sambar fellows, they are white but not strong. They don't need tables also. So this is rice eating bird. This is wheat eating, very strong fellows. That was 6 feet like that. And they are holding hands like that. Delhi Seva. They don't speak English. I don't know Hindi. I went there. I thought, but I thought they would give me a slap also. Dangerous to handle. They are holding their hands tight. Then what I thought about. When they were holding hands like that, I ran into the two arms. They did not stop me. And then Swami came there. Oh, that's why you are here. Come on and call me for the interview. I kept a cover in my pocket in the interview room. Hey, what that pocket? What is that? Cover. Have new dress for birthday. I gave you money, have to wear a new dress for birthday. Whose birthday? My birthday is October 25th, Swami said. No, 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 Swami's birthday. Why should I have a new dress for your birthday? Then Swami laughed and said, poor fellow, you don't know. I kept money for two dress addresses. One for your birthday, one for my birthday. Kept stitching charges also. Then I got both the suits stitched. Right from a schedule and little bit particular of dress. So I got two pairs ready. Swami, I attended his birthday. His Swami friends. That day I wore the dress meant for my birthday. He just looked like that. He just looked like that. And he just looked like that. The next day I wore the dress meant for his birthday. He came close to me and said, "Today's dress is better than yesterday's dress." Swami, this dress is for your birthday. It's bound to be better. Not only better, best too. They were namaskar and said that. That happened. And in the 79, he gave me another chance to speak. And Swami has gone up already. Come. And the winding steps, the senior people will be knowing. I have the steps inside, into your room. Winding steps. I just thunder, come.
Raja Dira, Raja Rama Chandra, Sai Jagavandana, Jaya Jaya Bhakunandana, Jaya Janaki Devana.
Raja Dira, complete, a wild velvet carpet on the ground. Yellow picture of the lion in the center. Swami's chair, velvet red colors. The cushion, Swami was standing there.
Very sweet Swami, smiling Swami, why is he like that? How can they face him?
He turned to me, oh, enough, come on, sir. And then he said,
I bring my talk to a close with one example. You know, sunflower, sunflowers blossoming, moving left side to side. Somebody asked, "Oh, sunflower, it's so beautiful. Why?" The sunflower said, "I do not know. Whom shall I ask? I do not know. You ask my roots. All roots. You made the flower blossom and shine. I do not know. What shall I do?" "Look up," roots said. I looked up, saw the sun, and the sunflower started speaking. "Oh Lord, you have touched me, and I have blossomed. You have touched me. Oh Lord, you have touched me. I have blossomed." Next part, next session. What is it?
एक पोयम पता के मैं क्लोज करूंगी। सरस संगीत साहित्य साईवांटकु सरस संगीत साहित्य साईवांटकु सरिगंचु चेर लिच्ची सहज सौंदर्य तेलुगु जिलूल मुंचप्पु सरुलु पेर्ची సహజ సౌందర్య తెలుగు జిలుగుల ముచ్చప్పు సరుగు పేర్చి ఆశు కవితలే మేల్పి బంగారు వటాణము చేసి ఘనముగా కీర్తిస్తూ కొలువంత సమస్తాన్ని ఏకంత స్వామికి ప్రేరణాశక్తి స్వామి ఆ సాయి లక్ష్మి కే రూప్ మే దర్శన్ దేతే హే శ్రావణ మాస్ మే హమ్ ఆప్కీ పూజా కర్తే హే వరలక్ష్మి కే రూప్ మే క్యా కే సక్తే హే ఆప్కో స్వామి हम तो सादा सीधे लोग हैं, ज्ञानी नहीं है, कुछ भी नहीं जानते हैं। आप जो भाषा हमको दिए उससे ही आपकी तारीफ करते हैं, इतना ही कर सकते हैं। आपके जो आपके आपकी भाषण से हमको कुछ आपकी भाषण से हम जो कुछ सीधा है उसी से आपके कार्य कर सकते हैं। आपको वरलक्ष्मी के रूप में सजाना चाहते हैं। फ्राइडे फ्राइडे को हम सब पूजा करने के पहले महालक्ष्मी को सजाते हैं ना, वो कलश लाते हैं, वहाँ रखते हैं और शाली पर कंची शाली से सजाते हैं स्वामी को और ज्वेल्स भी रखते हैं, ऐसा करते हैं। हम तो बहुत गरीब लोग हैं, आपको ये गहने भी नहीं दे सकते, क्या कर सकते हैं। कंची साड़ी तो हम मिलता है, शॉप में मिलता है, गनों भी वो हम मिलते हैं, लेकिन हम उससे नहीं खुशी, ये गहनों से ये साड़ियों से हमें खुश नहीं मिलती। आप जो सेवा हमें देते हैं करने के लिए, आपकी सेवा करने से ही हमें बहुत खुश हो सकते हैं।